Hello everyone, my name is Zehra Şahlanan. I am a fourth graduate student at İzmir Katip Çelebi University. I am going to present my graduation project named Channel Modeling Techniques for Visible Light Communication. These are contents of my graduation presentation. The objectives of this project are facilitate the calculation of capacity and efficiency in case of a possible scenario, to simulate any program using the targeted VLC technology with the system and to see any changes that need to be made instantly, to strengthen the shooting area with the help of VLC technology in every area with where 5G is used, and to provide quality data transmission to enable people working in the field of communication to benefit from this information by using the data. In this project, I compared results of both NetLab Channel Impulse Response Toolbox, Ray Tracing Channel Model, and Ceiling Bounce Channel Model. What is VLC? Visible light communication systems use visible light for communication occupying 380 nanometer to 780 nanometer spectrum. This corresponds to the frequency spectrum from 384 terahertz to 789 terahertz as shown in the figure 1. VLC systems are technology in which LEDs are used as transmitters and photodetectors are used as receivers. As a result of fast switching of LEDs, both lighting and communication can be achieved. The low bandwidth problem in RF communication is solved in VLC and resolved with the availability of broadband. Unlike fiber optics, wireless media is used instead of cables. Because the channel is wireless, light is emitted and reflected. Due to these properties of light, VLC technology has a shorter communication distance than other wireless communication systems. VLC applications are used in indoor, outdoor, underwater communication. The VLC receiver only receives signals if it is placed in the same room as the transmitter. Therefore, receivers outside the room of the VLC source will not able to receive the signals and hence will be immune to security issues of occurring in the RF. Link configurations. The efficiency of the optical wireless channel can vary greatly depending on the optical wireless link configuration. In the indoor environment, light will reflect from the ceiling, walls, and many other objects in the typical room or enclosure, but will not pass through opaque barriers. But in the outdoor environment, light will be scattered and absorbed by atmospheric conditions. There are various ways of configuring an optical link. Directive line of sight, DLOS. This design is created by directing optical transmitter towards optical receiver. Examples of areas where this design is used are point-to-point and simple peer-to-peer network optical wireless communication connections. Optics exhibit low power requirements due to their concentration in a very narrow ray, as well as creating a high power flux density in the photodetector. The DLOS connection configuration is shown in the figure 2. Non-directed line of sight. Non-directed line of sight consists of wide-angle ray transmitters, wide-angle field of view receivers used to expand the coverage area, and the light is scattered from surface in the room. Non-routed links are suitable for point-to-multicast application project. Thanks to the reflections from the surfaces of the projects inside the rooms, they solve the blocking problem and thus a high proportion of the transmitted light is perceived from a number of different directions in the photodetector. And DMOS connection configuration is shown in the figure 3. Non-directed non-line of sight. In this link configuration, line of sight connections between optical transmitter and optical receiver is not directly established and the incoming ray is not directly in the coverage area. This design is known as the common link configuration. In this configuration, an optical transmitter with wide rate deflection is directed towards the ceiling. Reflections from walls, ceilings, and objects are also used to connect with a large field of view optical receiver facing the ceiling, thereby communicating. Unfortunately, the distributed configuration maintains high path loss due to the lack of direct path and causes delay in transmitted data. The non-directed non-line of sight connection configuration is shown in the figure 4. Block diagram of BLC. As seen in the previous section, there are some topologies for indoor applications. We can classify these topologies in two parts. These are the degree of directionality of between the transmitter and receiver, and the existence of the loss path between transmitter and receiver. As you can see in the figure 5, the signal modulated by transmitted part become optical light to be detected by photodetector. After the photodetector detects an optical signal, it generates photocurrent in response and is transmitted to receiver. In this system uses intensity modulation with direct detection. In this modulation, intensity of an optical source is modulated by the RF or millimeter wave signal. The modulation happens through direct detection of the optical transporter and conversion with photodetector. Ray tracing based channel modeling. In the ray tracing model, calculations are made by assuming that the positions of the reflectors and their dielectric properties are known. When the receiver, transmitter, and reflectors are stationary, the effects of multiple received signals and time delays are fixed. Once a ray reaches the receiver, it stops and does not continue to move further. If the ray has not yet reached the receiver, it stops after reaching the user-defined number of reflections of K number and does not continue any further. Ceiling bounce channel modeling. The ceiling bounce channel modeling is designed with a closed form expression for the impulse response, assuming that the transmitter and receiver are positioned together parallel to the floor and directed towards the ceiling. In the channel DC gain calculations, a closed form result is obtained, taking into account the elimination of transceiver positions. This is the scenario that I use in my project. I use empty room scenario from MATLAB channel impulse response toolbox. This is the results section. First two figures are SNR graph and channel capacity graph of toolbox. These figures are ray tracing channel model, SNR graph, and channel capacity graph. These are ceiling bounce channel model, SNR graph, and channel capacity graph. Conclusion. In this system, which is intended to be designed, it is to be able to observe the output such as capacity, efficiency in any environment. Any living creatures, any object or objects, and any possible scenario with any link design. Thanks to the VLC channel modeling system, the work done in the field of communication will accelerate. The interpretation of different situations will be easier with the processing of the obtained data. More more efficient results will be obtained from the projects that will be realized with no efficient simulation results. Accordingly, the VLC system can be added to help existing base stations in order for users to access information faster and with higher quality. In accordance with the purpose of the project, ray tracing channel model and ceiling pulse channel model results were obtained to compare with toolbox results. The parameters used in the toolbox were added to while the models were being simulated. Although these two models are compatible with each other, half of results were obtained according to the toolbox results. Thank you for listening.